Okay, based on what we have learned just now, we learned about annuity method. Now we go for constant ratio method. Okay, so then constant ratio method in it, you have this formula. Okay, so and this formula. So this formula is actually from here. Okay, depends on the question whereby dia nak suruh kamu cari R kah atau dia nak suruh kamu cari the total interest. Okay, atau dia nak suruh kamu cari total interest. So dalam constant ratio method ini, there are a few things that you have to bear in mind. Okay, let us look at the formula here first. So dalam formula ini, R ini adalah the annuity, annual interest. Macam lah, interest rate is 5.8%, interest rate adalah 10% and etc. Then the second one is M. So M ini you have to be careful. Why? Because kalau soalan itu cakap based on monthly payment, okay, jadi M sama dengan 12. Kalau soalan itu cakap adalah based on weekly payment, okay, so M ini sama dengan 52. So M hanya ada 2. M ini hanya ada 2, whether is 12 atau 52. Baca soalan betul-betul. Okay, is either 12 atau 52. Then the this one is the total interest charge. Okay, B is original balance, and N adalah number of installment. So without delay, let us look at the example. Okay, let us look at the example here. Okay, the same question, more or less the same as annuity method there, apa yang kita belajar tadi. Okay, the washing machine sold 2000, this is a cash price. Through an installment purchase, the buyer has paid 400 down payment and 10 monthly installment. If the interest charge is 8% per annum on reducing balance. Kan saya sudah cakap tadi, reducing dia ada dua method. Kan? First is based on annuity. The second is based on constant ratio method. But when you want to selesaikan soalan, pastikan kamu tahu gunakan formula apa. Okay, pastikan kamu gunakan formula apa. Then let us look at the question again. Find the total interest charge, the monthly payment, and the installment price by using constant ratio method. Soalan ini adalah based on constant ratio method. Okay? Okay, now the first question here is to find out what is the total interest charge. So daripada sini, we cannot use I sama dengan PRT. We cannot use this. Why? Because the soalan ini adalah cakap based on constant ratio method. So let us go back here again. Kalau constant ratio method, you have these two formulas saja. Okay? Now, soalan itu cakap, find out what is the total interest charge, right? So what you can do is you can either use this formula or this formula. Okay, actually this formula, daripada formula ini, so I just focus on this formula, whereby which is R equals to 2MI divided by BN plus 1. Okay, this is a formula based on this formula. Okay, so 2. Okay, 2 sama sejak lah. Okay, 2. M here, you have to bear in mind whether dia adalah based on weekly or dia adalah based on monthly. So if you look at here, okay, soalan ini adalah based on monthly, whereby monthly payment. Okay, so here M ini should be 12. I ini adalah the total interest charge. This is what we need to find out. So we find out the I bahagi the balance. B ini adalah original balance. Tadi 2000 minus dengan 400, which is 1600. So your original balance will be 1,600 and adalah 10 tambah dengan 1. So R ini adalah the interest charge, right? The soalan itu sudah bagi kamu interest, right? Which is at percent per annum. Okay, so R ini adalah 0.08. So here, please use your calculator to find out what is your I. Okay, to find out what is. So based on my calculator just now, apa yang saya dapat adalah 58.67. I get 58.66666. Okay, so saya bundarkan, dia akan jadi the total interest ini adalah 58.67. Okay, so why we are using this formula? Why not PRT? Is because soalan itu sudah cakap selesaikan masalah based on constant ratio method. Based on constant ratio method. Jadi we have to use this formula. We have to use this formula. Not I sama dengan PRT. Okay? Now, let us look at B. Soalan ini minta the monthly payment. Okay? The monthly payment. So you look at the monthly payment. Okay? Monthly payment sama dengan cash price plus total interest divided by number of payment. So it's not cash price, but it's the original balance. So original balance is 1,600 plus the total interest here is 58.67 bahagi dengan the number of payment, which is 10. So how much you get? 1600 plus 58.67 divided by 10. So your monthly payment will be 165 ringgit and 87 cent. Okay, so that is your monthly payment. Now let us look at C. C ini cakap the installment price. Okay, installment price. Installment price, you ada dua formula kan? You ada dua formula. One is cash price plus total interest, atau down payment plus total monthly payment. So dua-dua ini kamu sudah ada answer. Whereby cash is either you can use this or use this, sama saja. So I choose to use this, which is cash price is 2,000 plus total interest is what I get just now, right? Total interest is 58.67. So 58.67. So I got is 2,058.67. Okay. If I don't want to use this, I can also use down payment, which is 400 plus total monthly payment. Let us look at here. Total monthly payment is 165.87. Right, 165.87 times 10. Okay, 400 plus 165.87 times 10. So you will get the same answer, this. Okay, so untuk reducing balance, I make a conclusion here. Dia adalah based on dua method. So it's either annuity method or it's either constant ratio method. Okay, these two method sahaja. So dalam annuity method, kalau soalan itu minta annuity method, mostly dia akan suruh kamu cari what is the monthly payment. Okay, kalau constant ratio method, dia either suruh kamu cari A atau dia akan suruh kamu cari the total interest based on the soalan tadi. Macam soalan tadi kan? So kalau soalan itu sudah cakap based on reducing balance, okay, then soalan itu suruh kamu cari the total interest. Okay, jangan-jangan kamu gunakan I sama dengan PRT. Kenapa? Sebab soalan itu cakap based on reducing balance. Okay? So that is for the subtopic here. Let us look at it again for the next subtopic, yeah.